This is Kurt Heisinger, accounting professor at Sierra College and author of Managerial Accounting. In this video, we're going to take a look at terminology as it relates to merchandising companies compared to manufacturing companies. In particular, we're going to focus on inventory costs and inventory accounts and how those costs flow over to the income statement in cost of goods sold. So let me zoom in a little bit on these terms so you can see them a little more clearly. As you can see here, the following terms up at the top are similar for both manufacturing companies and merchandising companies. So both types of companies, and by the way, merchandising is really the same as a retail company. So both types of companies use the term sales to represent the revenue that derived from the sale of products. Both companies tend to use cost of goods available for sale, cost of goods sold, operating expenses, selling general and administrative expenses, and operating profit. These are all terms related to the income statement. Then we get to some of the differences in terminology between a merchandising company and a manufacturing company. So in a merchandising company, they're going to use typically merchandise inventory as the account name, or something similar to that, as the account name to reflect the cost of inventory on hand for that company. Manufacturing companies will use the term finished goods inventory, really to mean the same thing. These are the goods that are completed by the manufacturing companies and ready to sell. And so that's the account that we would see on the balance sheet for a manufacturing company under assets. Manufacturing companies tend to use the term cost of goods manufactured, while merchandising companies tend to use the term net purchases. And both of those terms really reflect the cost of the goods coming into either finished goods inventory or merchandise inventory, depending on the type of company. So for a manufacturing company, cost of goods manufactured really relates to the cost of the goods that are completed and transferred out of work in process over into finished goods inventory. For retail companies, net purchases represents the cost of the goods that are really purchased from other companies rather than being produced internally. Here's an example of an income statement for a merchandising company. You'll see that it looks really similar to an income statement, the final product income statement for a manufacturing company, but with some slight differences. So at the top, it's similar in that we show the sales amount, the revenue for the company, and in this example, it's $450,000. And then next, you're gonna see the equivalent of the schedule of cost of goods sold that we saw for a manufacturing company. Most retail companies are simply going to show the cost of goods sold amount, but you see the entire schedule here so that you can see the similarity between this and a manufacturing company. So we start with, in this cost of goods sold area, with the beginning balance for merchandise inventory. Again, that's an asset account. And we see that it's $350,000 for this company. Then we add to that transfers in, or any purchases that we had during the month. That is, we purchased inventory from outside companies, and here that number is $260,000. And that gives us then the cost of goods available for sale. From there, we have two choices. Either we're going to sell these goods, or we're not going to sell these goods, and we'll still have them in our ending inventory balance. So our ending inventory balance was $320,000. If we subtract that from this $610,000 that's available for sale, that will tell us our cost of goods sold amount. So $610,000 minus $320,000 gives us $290,000, and that represents the cost of goods sold amount. If you think back to a manufacturing company, that was what we were calculating in the schedule of cost of goods sold, the cost of goods sold amount that appeared on the income statement. So we see the same thing here, but for a merchandising company. The rest of this tends to look the same as a manufacturing company. We have gross profit, which is our sales minus our cost of goods sold. We then subtract from that selling costs and general administrative costs. And $160,000 minus $90,000 minus $40,000 gives us, in this example, operating profit at the bottom of $30,000. So you'll see that the income statement here for a merchandising company is very similar to an income statement for a manufacturing company. The primary difference is we get our inventory from outside companies as a merchandising company, whereas manufacturing companies produce their own inventory.